as well as the energy flow. For this, two more marks, four marks we have received in the process of healing. One. And number third, if you control the mind, for example, you know that anything that is beyond our control, that can be controlled by a superior status which is activating it. Could you follow that? Anything can be controlled only by a superior force. That's why I explained in the science lecture, there are three types of people. Persons who are looking things in a lower level, persons who are visualizing the same thing in the equivalent level, persons who are seeing from a higher level. Could you follow that? Persons who are seeing things from a lower level is a common person. That is a society. There are three S. One is the society, second is the scientist, third is the seer. So the social community, the scientist community and seer community. The social community, they see everything from the lower level. They know that it is acting. They cannot answer why it is acting, what it is acting, and how it can be put to an end, how it can be augmented if you want, how you can throw if you don't want the society, they do not know. The equivalent envisioning is done by the scientist who can know at least some basic things. But they cannot understand the head and tail. Head, where does it come and where it ends, they cannot understand. The portion between these two things, they can analyze. The spiritual people can understand the two things. One is the teleology, the purpose or end, or ontology, the study of the fundamentals. It is apprehendable only by the spiritual people. So, could you follow that? Likewise, if you want to control heart, for these two marks, if you want to control heart, or heart diseases, or emotional control, whatever you want from heart, you must take a force which is not equivalent to heart or which is the heart itself. The same heart will not provide you the potency or the valency or the energy to cure itself. Or any part of the body like brain, somebody says that I will apply my brain. It is a different arrangement or configuration of flesh. If the flesh is arranged like this and if it pumps the blood, that flesh is known as heart. Same flesh is like this in the cranium ball within the cranium fluid. Instead of here valves, here we are having valves and vessels. There we are having nerves and neurons. What is the difference? A different arrangement of the same flesh in a different fluid, cerebrospinal fluid. Here it is blood. So different arrangement of the same thing, same wine in a different bottle. It cannot come for rescue. So understand this concept for getting 2 marks. I think that you will get a pass mark within today's lecture's finishing. 40 marks out of 100. Anything that cannot be controlled by itself. Rule number two, anything cannot be controlled by something which is equivalent or equistatus with that. So we are taking the potential governance of the factors of mind and strong determination now. Our belief in the super mind and hypercomputer of the universal network, the God, seeking his guidance or blessings or the sources in the form of nature and consciousness, we are going to take their support in developing the energy sources. So how to think, what to think and how to gain, we have answered 3 questions resulting in 6 marks. Follow that. Now, why to study cardiology? Already, there are some areas, you know that in a mechanical device, there are 3 parts. One is a delicate part. And second is a sturdy part. And the first thing is the primary or vital part. For example, if there is an engine, the vital part is the energy supply. Apart from which the sturdy parts are there. What are the sturdy parts? The parts that are having proper endurance. That is the durability. Their working efficiency. And nature of withstanding challenges. Pressures, collisions and contacts. If you do like this, it is friction. If you do like this, it is contact. If you do like this, it is collision. So starting from a friction, ending with a collision, there are different challenges. Like mechanical challenges, we are also having life challenges. We are having friction in relations, friction in financial sufficiency, friction in knowing things. And also comes contact is there, and contact benefits and ill effects are there. And collision is the area where we are getting fatal damage or we are getting fatality itself. So in these areas, the sturdy part of the mechanical device, it can withstand these things. And your freak, there is a freak and delicate mechanism inside those things, operation systems, which cannot endure. So that which cannot endure at all, that which can endure towards a particular limitation and demarcation, that we can endure anything, there are three things like that. So what is the position of heart? I want to say it differs from persons. For some people with good balance, physical, mental, intellectual, spiritual balance, it is a sturdy mechanism. For some people, it is a reasonably sturdy mechanism. For some people, it is a freak and useless mechanism. So this thing cannot be generalized. So before you are going to heal, this one mark you can put. Before you are going to treat the hearts, you must understand, sturdity is of two types. One is the person's sturdity. Second is the person's organic sturdity. Organic sturdity deals with the heart and its sturdity with functions. You follow that? The second type of sturdity is a mental sturdity. If a person is to be treated who is having a heart disease, even though the person may be having 10% of heart disease, if the mental sturdity is more, that person must be treated as a person with a very, very poor heart sturdity itself. Because the total impact of a person's sturdity or impact level of a person's disease is counted along with the mental balance and sturdity of a person. Even for small diseases, even for ant bite, there are people who are afraid as if they are with snakes, and people who are considering even scorpion and snake bites as ant bites, the strong determination they also exist. For treating a person, you must either give them confidence, care and courage, three C's. Confidence is not always positive. If somebody is going to die, giving confidence is not that saying that you will live for 100 years. Saying that you cannot live and the possibility is very limited, and asking the person to execute the maximum things that he can do in his lifetime, that is also a confidence. In Srimad Bhagavata, when Parikshit Raja was cursed to live just for 7 days, nobody were engaged in the process of doing some rituals for augmenting his longevity. They have understood that is 7 days, and 7 days the maximum thing that he can do, he has done, and that has resulted in the formation of Srimad Bhagavata Mahapurana. Likewise, confidence is not false hope. Confidence is not false hope. Confidence is not consolation. It is insulating the person with more endurance and more capability to bear and withstand circumstances. So you have to give confidence, care and courage. Courage, to give confidence, you must have insight. Because by seeing the peripheral, what confidence you can give? That's why doctor says, this is what I know. Rest of the thing God knows. You surrender to God, but pay the fees here. So confidence can be given only by people with insight. Courage can be given by only people, those who have knowledge. Care can be given by people only those who have hearts, who have the softer emotions of affection, altruism, humanitarian base, love for others, love for human beings, love for the affected and downtrodden people. So, to give courage, you have to develop your intellect. To give confidence, you have to develop your spirituality. To give care, you have to develop your humanitarianism. Your blend of three things will be going to be a very successful, infallibly successful healer. And we are going to, in the next class, I am going to give 10 exercises for developing courage, for developing confidence and developing care. So, heart, it is very essential, because I told most of the people, due to 5 reasons, they are having heart problems. Number one, now most of the people are in a dilemma. They are not clear whether they are eating food or manure or artificial fertilizers. That much, the artificial fertilizers, they are totally occupied the plantation kingdom, and in the pretext just having a small calcium, urea or potassium, they have been consuming vegetables. Now in the form of vegetables, they are consuming the same urea, calcium, potassium, nitrate and other things. So these things, what is the connection between this and that? These fertilizers, they are capable of eroding 2 major things. One is magnesium, second is iodine, which are very much essential for governance of your intellect and balance. And I am going to teach you the substitute for this thing, how to create your own iodine, that is not through Tata iodized salt. I am going to give you a substitute by Smara Sukta and Medha Sukta, and those who are in the Vedic tradition with Vedic mantras with Swara, and Agama mantras are also there. God has given everything for all. Nobody is excluded.